Today, I'm going to show you how to add a discount to your gift card and show that it's on sale on your product page. And I'm also going to show you how to do the automatic discount at checkout and the discount code as well. So let's jump into the dashboard and let's get started. Okay, so the first method I'm going to show you is the actual product page, right? You want the sale icon to appear right here so that they know automatically, oh, I'm getting a discount on this gift card. Okay, so that's what we're going to go ahead and do first. So let's head over to our product page for the gift card. Okay, this is where we are. And we're going to come down to where it says add variant. Okay, so we're not going to come down here where it says price. Okay, we're not going to change this here. You're going to be tempted to do that, but I'm going to show you why you don't do it from here. Okay, so we're going to do the add variant here. We're going to add the variant. Okay, and this is the screen that you will get. So we'll select the $25. So you have the denomination of $25. Now, what you want to do here is the price is how much do you want the customer to pay for this $25 gift card? Okay. So we're going to say it's $20, and then the compare at is $25. Okay. So they're going to pay $25. It's going to show that it's on sale because it's coming down $5, but the denomination, the value of that card is going to be $25. Okay. So let's go ahead and save that. Now let's head over to our product page. Let's refresh that for a moment. All right, and there we go. So now we have, when they land on this page, they say gift card, it's on sale, $20 for $25 denomination, score. I save you $5, okay? So let me show you, if we go here to add to cart for those $25, let's go ahead and view the cart. And here, as you can see again, that it says the Brew Therapy gift card is $20 right here, $20, $20. This is what they're going to pay for. And the denomination is $25. So when they go to purchase, use this gift card to make a purchase, it's going to have the $25 value. Okay. All right. So that is the one way that you can do it. Now let me go back. Let's go ahead and just do the second one. Let's do, and you're going to do this for each one of your denominations. Okay. So let's go ahead and do the 50, and we're going to do the same thing. Let's do 45. And again, we're going to use this as 50. Let's go ahead and save that. Okay. Now let me go back and show you the other screen where I showed you not to update the price on. Okay. So you will see that based on the variant that we used here, it automatically updates this price here. Okay. However, if you do it manually, it doesn't work. Don't know. Okay. So if I was to manually just enter it here within this variant section here. Let's do this. Let's do 90. And let's go ahead and save this. It reduces the price, but it doesn't have the sale icon. Okay, so let's do that. And let's come over here to the front and let's go ahead and refresh that. Let me go back to my gift cards actually. Okay, make sure I refresh that. Okay, so now we'll see that we did the $25. We did the $50, right? So it's $50 and 45. And then the 75, right? We now it says 70, so I'll pay 70. And then the 100, I will pay the 90 to get $100, but the sale icon does not pop up. Okay. And the original price is not strike through. Okay. But now it doesn't mean it's wrong. Let's go ahead and add that $75 to the cart and let's view the cart again. It still does the same thing. See, it's the you pay 70. But the denomination is 75. However, it doesn't have that sale icon like it does here when you use the add variant. Okay. All right. I hope I earned your a thumbs up. Subscribe for more Shopify tutorials. Now, the only disadvantage of doing it this way, even though it really looks great, right, to have the sale icon here, is that you have to then manually change the prices when you want it to go on sale and then when you don't want it to go on sale. Okay, so you just have to manually do this, and if you have a lot of variants it's cumbersome, but that is the nice way that how you can do the sale here without installing an app. Okay, so just using the gift card features that are here in Shopify. Now the second way that you can apply a discount is through discount, which is right here. Okay, so if you've never used a discount before, this is what you will have. You'll have just go ahead and create a discount right here. And these are the options that are available to you. Now for gift cards, you would only use the two options, which is the amount off. So if you want a percentage off or a dollar amount off, you would use this option here. The second option would be if you maybe purchase $50 worth of merchandise, you get a $10 gift card for free, right? So this is buy one, get one type of a discount. So that's this option here, okay? So let's go ahead and use the amount off product, and it'll take you here to our product discount, okay? So right off the top, you have two options. You either have a method of a discount code where you're telling them, if you want this discount, enter the code welcome at checkout, or you can do an automatic discount, which just automatically adds the discount to the customer's checkout. They don't have to do anything, okay? For example purposes, we're going to go ahead and use the automatic discount for today, but know that you can also do the discount code, okay? Within this title here, know that this, whatever you name this, is what the customer is going to see at checkout. So I'm just going to add $10 off gift cards. All right, so I'm just going to leave it like that. So I want them to be able to get $10 off no matter which denomination of gift cards they purchase. Okay, so here we go. In the discount value, I'm going to use the fixed amount, but you can also do percentage. So you can do 20% off. I'm going to go ahead and do the fixed amount and do $5 right here. And then it applies to, so we're going to do a specific product. So you can actually add a discount to a whole collection, but since we're talking about gift cards right now, we're just going to go to a specific product. And then here we're going to search the product. So you're going to browse. And here you have two options. You can either select here and it'll apply that discount to all of the four denominations I have, or perhaps maybe I only want the discount to apply to the $100 gift card. Okay. So you have the flexibility to choose which product you want, which product, which denomination, which variant you want that discount to be applied to. Okay, so let's go ahead and do the $100. Why not? All right, only apply discount once per order. So of course, I think that you would want to do that. Then we're going to come down to the minimum purchase requirement. So what is the minimum purchase amount do you want their customers to purchase before they can get this discount? And then also the minimum quantity of items. So you can also just have minimum. Maybe all they have to purchase is just the one thing, right? So you can do that. So you can select which one of those things you want. Then the combination, do you want this discount to be combined with anything else? Okay, so be mindful if you have other discounts out there, like if you offer a discount for joining your email list and that has a 10% off discount. So just be mindful of whether you want that to be combined or not. Totally up to you. And then for the active date is, when do you want that sale to begin? Do you want it to start the start date, and then at what time, and then set the end date? So let's say you only want this to be a 24-hour sale. So then you will set that for, you know, midnight, and the date, okay? And then you would just go ahead and save that discount. And then when customers add the $100 gift card to their checkout, it will automatically apply this $5 off or whatever percentage you have at their checkout. So how you want to go about this, it's completely up to you. It is your personal preference on whether you want the product page to say that it's a sale, or if you're okay with the discount automatically being applied at checkout, or maybe you just want to give them a discount code. If you wanted to have an automatic discount, the only disclaimer that I would advise is to make sure that you have it on your announcement bar and in the product description that there is a sale and that the discount will be applied at checkout, so that they know that, because it's not going to have the sale and they're not going to know, right? You want to make sure that they know that it's on sale, that they're going to be getting a discount, and encourage them to go ahead and make that purchase. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Give me a thumbs up, and I will catch you in this video.